Today I'm going to show you how I fixed my $3,000 CNC paperweight. This is a control box for the Onefinity CNC machine. And it stopped working, just out of nowhere. No loose wires, no loose connections. I contact tech support, it's under warranty, what do they want me to do? They want me to open it up and service it myself. Okay, that's fine. I have a little bit of electronics experience. I'm comfortable taking things apart and putting them back together. But, you know, for someone that's just getting into it for CNCing or, you know, milling or whatever you want to call it, I was a little surprised that they were asking me to take it apart for them. Their guide was pretty good, but it wasn't very clear on a couple points. So what I did was I filmed the whole thing. I went through all, I think it's like 9 troubleshooting steps. I found the problem and I resolved it. And I'm gonna share that with you today. This is the controller from Onefinity. It's based off the BuildBotix platform. I have to hand it to Onefinity. Their customer service has been pretty good. I was a little surprised when they asked me to troubleshoot this myself, given that the unit is less than a year old and still under warranty, but what the heck? Now I can show you guys how to do it. So the first step in their troubleshooting guide is to push this down, make sure it's depressed all the way. Okay, now we gotta get inside this thing. Don't these people know that woodworkers don't really need Allen keys? And if one of these doesn't work, then I gotta go to the store. Well, that's not a good start. It looks like I'm actually stripping out the Allen keys. Let's try something else. Definitely a little more disappointed right now. There we go. Okay. Ooh, baby. A little dusty in there. Okay, so the first thing they tell you to look for is an overabundance of dust, which there is quite a bit in here, so I'm going to look into that. And then they ask to see if this little green light, you can see it just barely there in the frame, that little green light, if that light is on when the E-stop is pressed. So the light's on, so that's a good sign. I'm gonna go ahead and blow this out real quick with the air compressor. They tell you specifically, do not use a vacuum on this because you'll fry the electronics. They're very sensitive. Okay, next they're telling me to look for a fuse on one of these red wires, and I don't have one because I'm one of the earlier models. Now it does have a main inline fuse in the unit back here, but they say to leave that one alone. Okay, the next thing they want us to look at is this cord right here. It says sometimes it can come loose on its own and cause it to not power up. Well, that was on there pretty darn good. So I'm going to count that as intact. While I'm here, I'm just going to check all the connections. Now the next step, we're going to find out if we have a bad switch on the unit. And now I have to open the front because you can't get to the switch from the inside. Okay, so the next thing they suggest to do is bypass the switch. So this is the on-off switch that isn't working. Now you can hear the fan isn't even engaging. Okay, so what we're going to do is with the power source unplugged is take these two connectors and put them together. Now I'm going to mark one with a Sharpie so that I know which one goes on the top and which one goes on the bottom. It shouldn't matter, but when I send it back to Canada, I want to make sure it goes back in the same way that I received it. Okay, so I have the switch bypassed, and now I'm going to add power. Okay, it is not a bad switch. Okay, I bypassed it. E-stop is off. Unit has power. Still nothing. I went ahead and opened up the fuse they told me. Let's see if I can get this to focus for you guys. I went ahead and checked on the fuse they told me to leave alone. Come on. There you go. And that bad boy looks really good. And the rabbit hole goes deeper. Now we're going to check the e-stop. I did, out of curiosity, just open up this fuse that they told me to leave alone. And it is intact and it looks good. So I put that back together off camera. But yeah, so now we're going to go ahead and we're going to bypass this e-stop and see if that'll do the trick. I have to say, it's been a while since since I've had a user serviceable electronic, and it's actually pretty nice. It's bringing me back to my robotics days in high school. We're going to bypass the e-stop, and we're pulling all six wires out just by loosening these screws. And I marked the single wires so I would know which ones go to this side of the e-stop switch. All right. Now, again, like I said, make sure you have the power off and unplugged. You don't want to find out the hard way. Now, they say to cover this with some electrical tape. Now, if I wasn't filming this for you, I probably wouldn't do it myself. But since I'm showing you how to do it, I'm going to go ahead and wrap it. Okay, we're wrapped. Okay, moment of truth. Let's plug it back in and see what we got going on. All right. So we have found our problem. Our problem is definitely the e-stop switch. Oh, that makes me so happy. I was afraid I was just going to have to send this on back to them and we wouldn't have a good conclusion. It's alive. All right, look at that. Bypass the e-stop, bypass the power switch, and it works. You can hear it running. Fan is spinning. That's always a good sign. Okay, so now that we found the problem, now we need to fix the e-stop. I'm going to go ahead and power down and unplug it while I do that. And just for S's and G's here, I want to make sure that the switch is good too. And it is. So that's good. So it's pretty cool how these work. This just pushes down and pushes these two little red breakers. They just push down. It's hard for me to show you. So everything on the e-stop seems to work fine, but it's not good. So there must have been a failure inside these breakers. I heard back from the company and they've told me to try to bypass one breaker on the e-stop. So that's what we're going to do. Now, lucky I just put these back in by hand.
I noticed that one side of these breakers was a little bit looser than the other. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it on, put all six wires on this side of the breaker. You can see the, let's see a little red breaker in there. And don't forget your screwdriver. When you seat these wires, you want to make sure that the copper is all the way in. You don't want to see any copper sticking out of the breaker. Okay, so let's give this a test. Thanks to Onefinity for solving my $3,000 paperweight problem.